Welcome to Norman, Oklahoma, and the heart of the Sooner Nation. Memorial Stadium already rocking with the sounds of Boomer Sooner. We're going to hear that all day. And wow, do we have a fun one here ahead. A top 10 team walking into the snake pit of an environment just trying to get out alive. This will be fun as we'll see the number 6 team in the country, the Alabama Crimson Tide, taking on the 14th ranked team in the land, the Oklahoma Sooners. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here in the booth by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, let's get to the action on the field. The Sooners will kick this away to start us off. And he takes this from inside the 5. Solid job by the coverage team. They bring him down at the 16. So Alabama's offense comes on the field to open this game. And there comes the star running back onto the field. He is a special talent. You talk to opponents, he's always the focal point when they face this offense.
Boy, Chris, this guy is special. It's almost like he floats across the field. I mean, I don't think anyone can take him down in the open field. He's the guy that teams try to key on, but sometimes it feels as though no one can contain him.
You know, in the era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example of a defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage and not give up big run plays.
Nowhere to run up the middle.
Boy, this defense is stepping up here early in this game, really controlling the line of scrimmage. Just nowhere to go on this last play. And now we've got a third down, a big opportunity for this defense to get off the field.
Listen to the crowd energy here in the early going. This is a tough, tough environment for visitors. Drops back, looking to throw for it on third down. Let's it fly out of the wideout. Looks downfield and connects with a wide open wide receiver. And they'll bring him down, but this offense creates a huge chunk play.
Boy, a huge play by this offense. A good throw, a nice, accurate throw. But I think it's the run after the catch that really impresses me. And early in this game, you got to think they're going to continue to go back to him until this defense shows that they can slow him down.
Looking to pass, it's Milroe. Here's a shot toward the end zone. Tried to press the ball deep, but it's incomplete.
You know, I like the quarterback's patience here, and instead of trying to force the issue and squeeze the ball into coverage, he just decides to just basically throw it away and live for the next down.
Second down after the incompletion. Off play action, he's looking to throw. Makes a quick grab. He makes the stop, but not before a solid gain that time. So a positive play, Kirk, with the crossing route. This is the defensive communication the coaches were worried about in this game.
Yeah, it really is a challenge in this call. When the offense goes with that deep crosser, that defense has to do a good job of communicating, really keeping their head on a swivel to understand who's coming into their zone. That time they just lost the receiver and they gave up a big gain.
Caught for the completion. Brought down at the 7, but the completion moves him into scoring position.
As quarterbacks, when you see man-to-man coverage, before the ball's even snapped, you're looking for a matchup that you want to exploit and take advantage of. This time, he waits for the back to find that matchup with the linebacker, makes the throw, and picks up a first down.
Second down, we're going to throw it. Here's a screen pass to the running back. Brought down, but the completion moves the ball down to the 4.
Well, it's so easy to get caught up in the receivers and the quarterback, and your eyes get lost. You forget about the running back. Nice catch and a first down for this offense.
And the crowd really making some noise now, trying to help out this defense to get this stop near the goal line. From the shotgun, drops back, makes the grab in the end zone. Touchdown, Bama.
Boy, this is a great way to start this game for this offense. Everything seems to be clicking. Quarterback's making great decisions. Here he makes a perfect throw to the receiver for a nice touchdown to get this game started right.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. PAT is good, so it's 7-0. Kickoff team is on the field to boot this one away. They'll return it from inside the five. And the coverage team pins him in and brings him down. So Oklahoma's offense out there for their first possession. Well, a wide receiver, Kirk, this dangerous, who lines up all over the place. Can the linebackers step up and help out the secondary enough today?
Yeah, usually you see these matchups, the slot receiver has a big advantage. But I'll tell you, this linebacker is an excellent athlete. But the wide receiver he's covering today will pose a textbook challenge to see if he can truly cover. Big runs like this are just demoralizing for a defense. It's one thing to give up big plays over your head against the pass game. But when teams can run the ball and pick up yards like this, really affects the team's mental psyche and their confidence. And you'll start to see some missed tackles following a play like this.
On first down, it's play action. Caught near the sideline. It's Anthony. And the runner scoots out of bounds after gaining some decent yardage.
Well, they don't pick up the first down here, but if you can use the quick passing game to stay ahead of the chains, it definitely helps your offense. And if that defense starts to creep up to take that away, that's when you can take a shot downfield.
The Sooners come to the line in the hurry up. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. They've got him at the 48, but that's a first down.
Well, a good run here and a great reminder of what the Sooners are all about. I know they've had quarterbacks that have gone on to win the Heisman in recent years, and Sam Bradford and Jason White and Kyler Murray, Baker Mayfield, all great players. But, man, when I think Oklahoma, I still think of them running the football with Barry Switzer. Option play, pitching it to the backs. Billy Sims, who won the Heisman. But DeMarco Murray and, of course, Adrian Peterson, Marcus Dupree. So great history, not just the quarterbacks, but running the football in Norman, Oklahoma.
What's the play call here on second down for this offense? To throw, it's Arnold. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. Tackled quickly after the catch, he'll be short of the marker. Nothing fancy there, just comes out of the slot and runs a slant route.
Yeah, it's so difficult for the defense to be able to slow this play down because it happens so quickly. Even when you know and might anticipate that this throw might be coming, it's tough to disrupt the timing when it's executed well like this right here.
Can he make it to the marker? Tackled at the 33, that's good enough for a first down.
Well, the scouting report on this running back was that he is an elite ball carrier, and he is proving to be that here early in this game. These first few carries, not only the strength, but the quickness and acceleration to get upfield and get positive yards on display.
And the Sooners lining up here on first and 10. Off the play fake, looking to throw. And he's going to fling it deep, going for it all here. Oh, and it's nearly picked off. Could not hold on to the ball in the end zone. Sets up second down.
Chris, we're all guilty of this. We all look at the big plays, the quarterbacks, the offense, how many points, how many yards. And sometimes we overlook the most important aspect of the game, the offensive line. You've got to do a good job consistently protecting the quarterback, and it all comes down to the offensive line. And here, they hurry the quarterback, and they blow up the play.
Defense reacts quickly, a very short gain on the play.
Again, this is a really nice job here by the defense, keeping everything in front of them in that situation. Now, they're rewarded with this third and long. We'll see if they do the same thing here, or are they going to sell out and bring the pressure.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Dropping back. We're going to throw for the first down. Grab down the middle. It's Anthony. The tackle is made, but the offense is now set up with a first and goal from the 8.
Well, this is why this guy's one of the top wide receivers in college football. It's third down. The defense knows you're probably going to go to him, and they still can't stop him from coming down with a big play.
The Sooners come to the line looking to crank up the tempo. Here's the handoff on first and goal. And he'll make it in for the score. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Can you say methodical? A marathon march, Kirk, just pounding away and wearing down that defense.
They just kept moving the sticks and moving the sticks until they got into the red zone, and they just kept moving the sticks until they got into the end zone. What a drive.
Now they line up to kick the extra point. And the PAT is good. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. Fields it inside the 5-yard line. Defense makes the tackle here on the final play of the first quarter. We are deadlocked at the end of a fun, competitive first quarter. Let's check out the stats so far. And after a promising start, we hope that both teams will just continue with more of this action. Alabama's offense coming back onto the field. Great possession last time. They punch it into the end zone. Can the defense come up with a stop this time? And the senior able to make the stop after a short game.
Defense does a really nice job here of being able to contain that run game, held them just to 2 yards. Chris, to me, this changes the playbook a little bit now for the offense. The guy calling the plays at second and eight, that's a different deal. Now he's got to probably thinking about going through the air instead of staying on the ground.
The shotgun running play call. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Offense looking to keep the drive alive. It's third down. Off the play fake, looking to throw the football. Fires it to the wideout. Easy throw to a wide open receiver downfield. Oh, and he's in the clear now. It's a foot race. And he takes it all the way to the end zone. Touchdown, tied.
Well, that's a well-oiled machine right there. Everyone on this offense has been a star in their roles. And when they're rolling like this, it results in quick and positive results.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. And the extra point makes the lead 14-7. Now the kickoff team is out on the field. To make a play here. He tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. And the Sooners offense is back on the field. Can they keep it going? They mixed the run and pass beautifully in the last touchdown drive. They'll tackle him out across the 20.
That's exactly what you want to see as a play caller. You get positive yards to be able to kind of keep you on schedule as a play caller. That's all you can ask for. Good job up front and a nice run.
The Sooners hustle to the line to crank up the tempo. Quarterback still with the football. Not much on that play. Brought down short.
Not exactly the outcome this offense was hoping for here on the option. They didn't lose any yards, which is great. I think they're definitely looking for more from that play.
It's third down for the offense. Dropping back, it's Arnold. He flips it to the back across the middle. Brought down to the 28, and it's good enough for a first down.
What a clutch play here by this offense to convert on third down. I know it's still early in this game, but the fact that they've dug themselves a hole to convert there and keep this drive alive, they got a new set of downs and a chance to dig into this lead.
And the Sooners begin a new series here, first and 10. Caught over the middle, it's Anderson. They stop him after a 6-yard gain, so second and 4.
Well, the defense didn't have any time at all to get pressure on the quarterback. He gets the ball out of his hands pretty quickly on the hitch to the receiver.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Trying to find room. It's Sawchuk. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2.
Boy, this defense is strong up front. Linebackers are flying downhill, able to make plays against this run game. Now they get this offense to another third down. Now you pressure that quarterback and try to build on the lead.
Offense operating at high tempo now, no huddle. On third down, he drops to throw. Looks downfield and finds a receiver who worked his way wide open. You get him down at the 41, but that's good enough for a first down.
Chris, that's a great example of his arm strength. He just fired the ball in there much quicker than the defense could even react.
The Sooners pick up enough for a first down. Off the play fake, looking to throw. He's escaped. Here's a fumble way behind the line of scrimmage. He scooped up the ball. It's still a live play.
The offensive staff just took a collective sigh of relief. But I'd still anticipate that someone's going to pull that ball carrier aside, give him a couple choice words on the importance of ball security.
That sack sets up a second down and long. Looking downfield, it's Arnold. And it's intercepted. Beautiful timing there. Going the other way, can they stop him? Touchdown, Crimson Tide. Wow, what a play, a defensive score. And the interception taken to the house, a pick six, potential game-changing play there.
Man, nothing gets a defense, and especially a defensive coordinator, more fired up than a pick six. And let's not forget, give credit to some of those other defenders for making some key blocks to spring that touchdown loose.
And they'll set up now for the extra point try. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. He's going to return it from near the goal line. And he stopped at the 19. Good job by the coverage team. And the Oklahoma offense is back on the field. It'll be interesting to see if this quarterback can bounce back. He threw a pick six in the last possession. Quarterback keeps the football. And they make the stop to get the ball carrier down.
That's exactly how you want to defend the option. You know, the old school way is assignment football. You have to account for the quarterback, the pitch man. Here, the quarterback had really nothing other than just kind of lower his head and get as much as he could. Fortunately for the defense, it wasn't very much.
The Sooners looking to crank up the tempo a bit. Looking to pass here on second down. Caught quickly. And they bring him down quickly, but that's a solid gain on the short throw.
Chris, the more we watch these spread offenses attack in today's game, it's not just about the vertical shots with the taller receivers on the outside. Defenses are challenged even more by those smaller slot receivers and their quickness in space.
So a very makeable third down for this offense from the 26-yard line. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. Receiver makes the grab, and the gain just good enough for a first down.
Well, it's third down. The defense knows he's going to get the ball. You still can't stop the quarterback finding this receiver to be able to pick up another first down for this offense.
So it's a first down here. The clock is stopped temporarily, but they'll get to the line quickly. Looking to pass, it's Arnold. Catch made on the left side. Really solid first down gain. He's just short of the marker, so maybe a chance here to take a downfield shot.
The key on a drag route is to put the ball out in front of the wide receiver to give him a chance to do what he just did. Pick up some valuable yards after the catch.
They'll crank up the tempo here on second down. The time is running out. And the quarterback looking to make a play through the air. Quick throw to his receiver. That one falls incomplete. Looking for a flag, doesn't get it. Brings up third down. Looking to throw again. He's got it for a big gain. Tackle made at the 41. That's first down yardage. And a timeout is called. Important stage late here in the second quarter. And the Sooners getting set on first and 10. Catch made over the middle. They bring him down, but that gain moves the ball all the way to the 31.
One thing we know for sure, I don't know if as a play caller you can make that call without a quarterback who can throw it with a big arm. He put that on a rope.
First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? He snap it. Quarterback looking to throw the ball. Let's it go quickly. And he pulls in the catch. Finally marked out after a big game. But hold on. There's a penalty marker on the field. Let's check this out. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. The Sooners line it up with first and goal. That one falls incomplete. Good defensive play. Brings up second down. Back to pass. It's Arnold. And he makes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
Love to watch this quarterback go out and execute in this kind of situation. He's doing a great job of ignoring the scoreboard and feeling a sense of pressure to have to play with more urgency. Right now, he's executing. We're only in the second quarter. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
They're set now to try the PAT. The extra point is good. They're down by a touchdown, 21-14. So the offense getting some momentum before halftime with the touchdown. Now they kick off in hopes the defense can get a quick stop. And here's the return from inside the five. He'll be tackled at the 27. That's where the drive will start. Here comes the Alabama offense onto the field. They've got to be pleased with their performance here in the first half. Let's see if they just play it cautious and get to the break in front. And the tackle is made. The screen pass there produces a solid gain. The offense will quickly spend a timeout here after the play.
And the defense is getting pressure on the quarterback. They got a little bit fooled here by the screen play. Nice positive gain for the offense.
Quarterback looking to pass here on second down. Grab behind the line. It's Miller. And a quick timeout call by the offense after the play.
Well, the offensive line does everything they can to try to protect the quarterback, to give him enough time to find an open receiver. But there's nobody there downfield. He ends up throwing it to the back. But how about the speed of this defense? Now, you're looking at a third down.
Looking to scramble. Enough for the first, but still going. And the offense will now quickly spend a timeout.
Man, nothing is more aggravating for a defensive coordinator than this right here. You've got him. You've got a chance to make a play on him, take him out of his rhythm, but instead, this guy gets away from that pressure, tucks it, and picks up some big yards.
And it's incomplete, just out of the reach of the receiver.
Man, Chris, I don't know if that was a bad read by the quarterback or a bad route by the receiver. They got to get this cleaned up before the next time they go through the air.
Offense getting set. It's second down. Looking to throw. It's Milroe. And he'll loft it to the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Alabama. Looked like a total bust there. Easy pitch and catch like you'd see in a Tuesday practice.
Yeah, that quarterback's eyes must have lit up on that play because you've got one of your players way downfield without any defender around him.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. With the extra point, the lead is 14. So an important touchdown just before halftime. Not much time for the opposing offense to try to answer before the break. He'll return it from inside the 10-yard line. He'll be tackled at the 18. That's good coverage there. So the offense takes the field in the final seconds of the half. Chance for just a couple more plays. They'll give it to the running back. He shreds the tackle. We're gaining some breathing room now. Tackled at the 26. And that will do it for the first half here. Kevin Connors now has our halftime update.
Guys, you've been calling a lively one from Norman so far. And it'd be easy to say these two offenses are glad we've hit halftime based on their respective performances. It would also be accurate. Turnovers and sacks have told the story so far. And you gotta believe the play calling has been the issue, right? Time to shred those game plans and just get back to basics. That said, let's get back to the field and our guys in the booth to start the second half.
Alabama will kick it off to start the second half. He's going to bring this out a few yards deep in the end zone. He'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. Okay, so here comes the Oklahoma offense back on the field. And they'll start the third quarter here on the ground. The Sooners hustle to the line to run the hurry up. Gonna run it. It's Sochuk. Oh, they test the middle there, but get nothing.
That's a great play all around by this defense. Your first level defenders hold their own at the point of attack, allowing the second and third level players to roam free and make the tackle close to the line of scrimmage.
Urgency now for the offense. They'd hate to come up empty on this drive down multiple scores. Dropping back, it's Arnold. On the run here, lets it go. Snags a quick throw. Defense wraps him up after a 6-yard gain. brings up fourth down.
Well, a lot of times when a quarterback sees man defense, he wants to get the ball out of his hands as quickly as possible. Put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle or two on the outside and get a big play.
And the Sooners will line up to punt it away. And this will be fair caught at the 35-yard line. So here comes the Alabama offense back onto the field. They've really built momentum in this game. They've been hard to stop. Can the defense make some adjustments, come up with a stop here? He's brought down out at the 46.
Man, you know, the back gets a lot of the attention here, and he's a good back. I love to see that offensive line win the battle of the line of scrimmage.
Now here comes the bunch formation. Makes a quick catch. Looks like Alabama will have the first down.
Boy, Chris, great timing here with the quarterback against that zone defense, waiting just at the right time to deliver it into that window to pick up a nice game.
So the ball placed right at midfield as the offense starts with a first and 10. And now the handoff. He picks up 9, so just short of the first down, second and 1.
Just love watching this back run. Gets behind that offensive line, lowers his pads, and gets a nice solid game.
Offense getting set. Second down play here. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. Grab made by the tight end. Tackled, but only after picking up a fresh set of downs. Tackle is made, but the junior quarterback shows off his arm strength that time.
You know, plays like this are what Alabama offense is all about. They run the football, and then they're efficient within their passing game. Think about it. They won a couple national championships with Greg McElroy and A.J. McCarron by just being efficient and playing smart at the position and being a great complement to that running game in the defense.
And there's the handoff. Gets the first and still running. And he's brought down, but not before he gets first down yardage.
Every now and then, we see a really good run. We tend to focus on what other people did in order for that run to happen, what the offensive line did. Maybe the receivers are blocking good on the edge. Sometimes, the running back is pretty good, too. And on that play, he picked up a lot of yards and made that happen with good effort.
Looking for 6, and it's caught. Touchdown, Bama. That's just nice execution. Quarterback and receiver Kirk perfectly in sync that time.
Yeah, you can see why route running is one of the most underrated attributes of a receiver. It's easy to get caught up on their ability to catch or their vertical or their speed, but nothing substitutes for someone who can create separation like this before the ball is even thrown.
Extra point try coming now. The extra point is good, and they stretch the lead a little bit more. Now they get set to kick it away. Return starts from inside the 5. Makes it to the 16. That's good coverage there. And the Sooners offense is back out on the field. Last time was a quick 3-and-out. Can they get a drive going this time? First play of the drive, he looks left for a completion. They bring him down, but the drive has now reached the 35.
Another Oklahoma receiver making a big-time play for this offense. Man, it just seems like over the years, so many big-time dynamic receivers have come to Norman. Integral piece of this offense, and it gets you the yards you need.
The Sooners will come to the line to crank up the tempo. It's a quick grab.
This is an example of a quarterback and his offense just taking what the defense gives you. Not a huge play, but positive yards. The defense wants to give that throw to you. You take it, get the ball to your receiver, stay ahead of the sticks.
Second down play coming up for this offense. Handoff here from the shotgun. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. Think about quickness. That play is absolutely blown up in no time.
Chris, I don't know if that's a missed assignment by the offensive lineman or just really good instincts there by the defender, but that play is blown up right at the snap.
Third down. This offense could really use a conversion here, down multiple scores. Looking downfield, it's Arnold. It's intercepted, trying to fire it into a tight window. They bring him down after a short return, but the takeaway sets up the offense near midfield.
Boy, would this quarterback love to have this one back. They're trying to work themselves back into this game here in the second half, and the defense comes up with a big turnover that could be the nail in the coffin.
Here comes the Crimson Tide offense onto the field. This has been a dominant performance so far, up double digits at the break, building on the lead here in the second half. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. So this defense finally makes a play. That's one of the few negative plays for this offense today.
Yeah, you said it, Chris. They don't have the easiest road to climb back in this one, but little plays like that can be points of positivity of what coaches will likely focus on as they move forward.
Important second down play coming up. There's the snap. Quarterback setting up to throw. Caught over the middle. He's taken down, but that's a nice gain. They'll spot the ball now at the 35.
You know, Chris, if we would have told Bear Bryant that Alabama would have a wide receiver that won a Heisman in recent years, I don't think he would have believed us. But that's where we are. They've been some great ones in the past, and we're seeing some great-looking receivers on this unit right now.
Grab behind the line. It's Prentice. Defense surrounds him. Just a short gain on that completion.
These undersized slot receivers can be some of the toughest guys to contain for a defense. They're quicker than they really are fast, and they're very elusive, tough to contain in these one-on-one matchups.
Getting set. Here's second down. It's a shotgun run call. And the tackle is made on what's going to be the final play of this period. So Alabama will take the lead into the quarter break here. And they got to be feeling pretty good about things as we wrap up the third quarter. Let's review how we got here. And now entering the final period of play, is there an epic comeback in store? We're going to find out. In the third and short, they'll try to throw for it. And he dumps it off to the tight end. And they pick up the first out of the 23, getting closer to the red zone.
Well, this quarterback is unflappable. Here they are working with the lead in the second half. Get to a third down. You got to throw the football. This is where you trust the quarterback to make a good decision, an accurate throw. He does it. You convert, and you keep working that clock.
First down. Looking to throw the football. And a short pitch and catch to the tight end. They bring him down at the 7. The offense set up now with a first and goal.
I mean, Chris, look at this guy. I mean, you talk about having a great day throwing the football and leading his team to a nice, comfortable lead late in the game, and it continues. The coach is showing confidence of what he can do.
Alabama's offense now lining up on first and goal. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Launching one to the end zone. Touchdown, tied. And this one is getting ugly.
Well, you talk about a dream performance by this guy. That's his fourth receiving touchdown of this game. We knew he'd have chances to make plays, but I don't think anybody expected four touchdowns.
Hold on here a second. The replay booth has signaled they want to take another look at this one. Looks like they got the ruling on the field right the first time. They confirm it with the review. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. Getting set to kick the ball off now. Returner choosing to field this one. And the returner brought down by the coverage team there. And the Sooners offense is back on the field. The last possession ended in an interception. Let's see if they continue to trust this quarterback in the passing game. He's got an open man downfield, and it's caught. They bring him down to the 38, but that's good enough for a first down.
Boy, really nice throw here to the slot receiver, and I love the quickness that he has after the catch. He's essentially a running back playing at that slot position. That's how dangerous he is after he makes a catch.
So one play moves the ball to the 38. It'll be first down. Looking to throw. It's Arnold. Fires it to the wideout. The defender gets a hand in there to break the pass up.
Oh, my gosh. They almost came up with another interception. They had a pick on the last drive. They're doing such a good job of baiting this quarterback into throwing the ball into coverage and then making a play on the ball. Let's see if they can keep this going.
Incomplete. Second down coming up. Quarterback drops back from the shotgun. And he finds a wide open receiver. They forgot about him downfield. And a big gain moves the ball across midfield all the way to the 39.
You know, we talked this week with the offensive coordinator about what makes this receiver so special. He kept referring to his route running. Here's an example of that. Great route, enough separation to give the quarterback a nice lane to throw the football.
And now they run the draw play. They've got him after a 7-yard gain, so second and 3.
The draw is a good way to keep the defensive line in check and use their aggressiveness against them. It can be real effective, even in passing situations, if you mix it in correctly.
Second down after that run on the previous play. And the quarterback dropping back. And it's incomplete that time, just out of reach of the receiver.
Well, they don't make the completion here. The timing seemed to be off between a quarterback and the receiver. But, man, this defensive coordinator, he may want to consider getting more pressure on this quarterback by changing some things up. He's got a lot of time back there to throw the ball. And eventually, that's going to cost you.
On third and short, they'll try to throw for it here. And this pass is on target, caught. Tackle made after a nice pickup on the play.
Really good job here of converting by this offense. And let's face it, at this point in the game, because they have such a big hole to climb out of, they've got to be able to convert and come up with a new set of downs. They do it here. Now they got a real shot to cut into this lead.
Looking to throw it from the red zone. Caught in the backfield. It's Sawchuk. Got a lane. Can he get in? Touchdown, Oklahoma. This offense is still clicking.
Love this never-say-die attitude from this quarterback. He's still slinging it out there. This game's out of reach, but this guy's still putting the ball in the air, and this one's a touchdown.
Now the all-important extra point. And it's good. I believe they're going to line up here and go for the onside kick. And the hands seem able to make the crucial recovery. Alabama's offense coming back onto the field. They were up double digits at halftime, and they're just continuing to roll, building on the lead here in the second half. The gain is 4, so it's 2nd and 6.
Hat on a hat up front. Good job opening up the holes. Anytime you can get positive yards on first down, that's a win.
A gain makes it 2nd and medium. They'll use that running game, trying to bleed the clock here. Able to fight for a decent gain here in that running play.
Hey, it's a great job of running the football. It's the right idea, but the back's got to stay in bounds. Because remember, with the new rule in college football, the clock still stops momentarily until the referee sets the play clock for the next play, and then it'll start again. So stay in bounds and work that clock.
third and short, they try to pick it up on the ground. Moves the football to the 30. Good enough for a first down.
Yeah, I like this call here late in the game like this with the lead. Nothing too fancy, just right up the middle. Trust that offensive line and this running back and just keep working that clock.
First down here, the offense has time for one more play before the two-minute warning. Alabama getting set with a first and 10 now. He hands it off from the gun. Try to run it up the middle, but get nothing.
Chris, textbook job by the defense surrounding the runner and preventing that play from being bounced to the outside.
Second down after that previous play. Shotgun formation. Here's an inside handoff. Offense needing to keep this drive alive. It's a third down play. From the shotgun, handoff inside. Take it down, but not before he makes the first down.
Boy, this offense just seems to get more confident as this football game is played out. They've got a nice lead. Here they are in the fourth quarter, just working that clock, possessing the football, and trying to get out of here with a nice, solid victory.
You're pounding away with the running game. It's first and 10. Takes the handoff. It's Miller. And that's a solid gain before the defense able to bring him down.